In this video, I'm going to show you the workflow of capturing and creating high-quality digital materials using the HP Z Captis with Substance 3D Sampler. The HP Z Captis is a material capturing device that connects to and works directly within Sampler. With this integration, Sampler can preview and launch the capture, automatically process the PBR channels, and ultimately export a digital material. This functionality is currently available for all users with an enterprise, teams, or education substance license. So let's dive right in and learn how to prepare, capture, digitize, and render your materials using Substance 3D Sampler. If you're performing your first capture using the HP Z Captis, it needs to be configured to work correctly. So place the technical area in the center of the scanning area. Now launch Sampler and click on the plus button on the left bar. In the connected devices list, you should find the HP Z Captis. Sampler will initialize the preview of HP Z Captis device. At this time, do not interrupt the initialization and let the process complete. Next, you will see an alignment button. The alignment must be done the first time you set up your device as well as every time you physically move it. It is also recommended every couple of months to ensure accuracy and consistency. Click on a part of the technical areas to complete the setup. Once this is done, place the technical areas back in their original place and now you are ready to start scanning your materials. To prepare a material to be scanned, start off by opening the tray and placing your material in the scanning area. The material can be up to 30 by 30 centimeters and with the studio mode up to 1.5 centimeters in height. To ensure the material stays in place, use the magnets which are provided with your device. Once you're satisfied with the placement and the material is completely flat, you can close the tray and you're ready to begin capturing. Back in Sampler, start the capture process and you will start seeing the preview of your material. The first step is to adjust the camera focus. Clicking on Auto will ask you to select where to focus on the preview. It is advised to usually focus 1/3 of the center of the material sample. Then, you can adjust the camera exposure by selecting the intensity. Clicking on Auto will ask you to select the area of the material to calculate the intensity. Finally, you can calibrate the color of the base color map using the HP Z Captis technical areas. The color calibration is essential for matching the colors of the digital material with the original sample you're scanning from. This is only available in the studio mode. The next step is to define the region of interest or the capture area of the sample. Obviously, the smaller the area, the less time it takes to process the capture. Now define your project name, the type of output, and the resolution of the capture. The output has two dynamic range options, low dynamic range and high dynamic range, and you can also turn on the photometry option. The maps captured in the studio mode are the base color, normal, height, and opacity. More maps will be added in the future updates. There are two capture resolution options, 2K and 8K. To get the highest quality material, we'll choose the full resolution of 8K. Now go ahead and start the scan. The preview will start displaying the photos taken during the capturing process. To understand what is happening, the processing operations are split into two stages. The first stage is capturing all the required photos to construct the digital material. The second stage is processing all the photos to generate the PBR channels, including base color, normal, height, and opacity. During the capturing and processing, you can also add metadata that matches what you will find in Sampler metadata panel. Once the capture is complete, you can review the maps in the summary to ensure the capture has been successful. If you are satisfied with the results, simply save and exit. So now you have your newly captured PBR material in Sampler. You can choose to use it as is, or you can further process it to get the look you're after. To facilitate this, the channel switch includes base color, normal, height, and opacity have automatically been added to a layer in the Layers panel. This means you can add filters and processes to these channels to customize and tweak the outcome. For example, I'm going to add the Equalize filter, which is going to help equalize some of the color values of the base color. I'm also going to add the Content Aware Fill tool, which allows me to remove some of the artifacts from the color map. Once you're happy with the results, you can save your material. You can export the material in a number of ways. You can choose to output just the maps or export it as SBSAR. the files can then be loaded into different applications supporting these formats. And don't forget, it is also possible to send a material directly to a third-party application that supports the send-to operation. This concludes the workflow of scanning and creating high-quality digital materials using the HP Z Captis and Substance 3D Sampler.